Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. After finishing with the external features of the brain and spinal cord, we will start with the internal features of the brain and spinal cord and also other associated structures. So, internal structure of the brain. Now, cerebrum consists of gray matter and white matter. Gray matter is outside. White matter is inside. The gray matter of the cerebral hemisphere has a special name known as the cerebral cortex. So a section to the cerebral hemisphere, it shows gray matter outside. Gray matter is outside and white matter is inside. And the gray matter is specially known as the cerebral cortex. Still in the white matter there are masses of gray matter. Still embedded in the white matter there are masses of gray matter known as the basal nuclei. Now the gray matter, this is supposed the gray matter of the cerebral cortex. And deep to it is the white matter. A piece of cerebrum showing gray matter outside and white matter inside. Now gray matter of the cerebrum, that is cerebral cortex, it comprises of parts of neuron. Now, which parts, that is cell bodies, dendrites and initial parts of axons. Parts of neurons, gray matter also comprise of supporting special supporting cells known as the glial cells, and gray matter is also occupied by blood vessels. This is a summary of the structure of gray matter of cerebral cortex. I suppose I will draw one part of the one neuron. This is cell body of the neuron. From the cell body, dendrites arise. Several branching processes, dendrites, and one process called axon. So this is gray matter. Inside is part of the neuron, the cell body of the neuron with nucleus and several branching processes known as the dendrites, and a single process, the initial part of which is in the gray matter known as the axon. Now these neurons, they are supported by glial cells. There are different types of supporting cells, special supporting cells known as the glial cells, and there are blood vessels. So parts of neurons, glial cells and blood vessels. This is the summary of structure of the cerebral cortex, gray matter. Now white matter of cerebrum. Comprise of axons, which are also known as nerve fibers. Glial cells. And blood vessels. The white matter, which lie deep to the gray matter, also comprise of certain structures. That is axons of the neurons. Axons of the neurons are the processes which are also known as the nerve fibers. Then these neurons, they are supported by special connective cells known as the glial cells, and there are blood vessels. Now I told you that initial parts of the axons are in the gray matter. from the gray matter, the axons enter the white matter and traverses through the white matter. This is axon or nerve fiber of a neuron. The body of axons or nerve fibers are located in the gray matter. So this is one neuron. Part of it is in the cerebral cortex, gray matter, and part in the white matter. Now cell body is with the nucleus, dendrites, initial part of the axons, they are in the gray matter. And from the gray matter, the axons passes inside through the white matter. So the white matter will comprise of axons or nerve fibers of the neurons. In this diagram, I've shown only one neuron. There are millions of such neurons. Now, these neurons are supported by glial cells. So here again, in the white matter, there are glial cells, different types of glial cells. And there are blood vessels in the white matter also. This is the structure of white matter. Now, these axons, as they leave the gray matter and enter into the white matter, they become myelinated. They are covered by a sheath known as the myelin sheath. So these axons are nerve fibers. These are myelinated. That is, these axons in the white matter, they are covered by a special covering known as the myelin sheath. Part of the axon or nerve fiber, which is in the gray matter, is non-myelinated. Cell body, dendrites are non-myelinated. But as the axon enters the white matter, immediately it is covered by a myelin sheath. The axons or nerve fibers in the white matter are myelinated. Now, what is myelin sheath? And why the white matter appears white in color with the naked eye? Now, if we suppose this is a cut end of an axon. This is a nerve fiber or axon. The cut end of the axon. Now, it is covered by myelin sheath. Several layers of cell membrane encircle around the axon. In the center, this is cross-section of an axon or nerve fiber in the white matter of the cerebrum. And the axon is covered by myelin sheath, which comprises of several layers of cell membrane. And this, between the layers of cell membrane, there is lipid deposition. Between the layers of cell membrane, there is a lipid deposition. Now, this covering of the axon, which is comprised of several layers of cell membrane with the lipid deposition between the layers, is known as myelin sheath. And this is the cell, the glial cell, which produced myelin sheath around this axon. Now this glial cell, which form myelin sheath in the white matter of cerebrum, is known as oligodendrocyte. This is nucleus of the oligodendrocyte. This is cell membrane of the oligodendrocyte. Inside is the cytoplasm and other organelles. And the cell membrane of the oligodendrocyte, it is wrapped around the axon several times. When the cell membrane of the oligodendrocyte is wrapped around the axon tightly, what happens? The cytoplasm is squeezed out. And several layers of cell membrane which belong to the oligodendrocyte encircle the axon. Between the layers of these membranes, the cytoplasm is squeezed out, but lipid deposition occurs. Fat deposition occurs. Now this structure, this covering outside the axon is known as myelin sheath. For example, you take a steel bar. Iron bar or steel bar. Then you inflate a rubber balloon. This is a balloon, a rubber balloon, inflated with air. Then what you do? You pick the rubber membrane of the balloon, stretch it and wrap it around the steel bar several times. When you wrap the rubber of this balloon, what happens to the air inside? The air is passed out, squeezed out, and several layers of the membrane of the rubber of the balloon is wrapped around this steel bar. So same is the case here. The cell membrane of the oligodendrocyte encircle the axon several times tightly so that the cytoplasm is squeezed out, and between the layers of cell membrane around the axon, there is no cytoplasm, but it is replaced by a thin layer of lipid. This lipid enriched layered structure surrounding the axon is known as myelin sheath. Because this myelin sheath is occupied by fat, this is why that the white matter appear white in color. So the parts of the axons of the neurons, which are located in the gray matter of cerebral cortex, when they traverses through the white matter of the cerebrum, they are immediately covered by a sheath known as the myelin sheath. And this myelin sheath, which covers this axon in the white matter, is formed by the oligodendrocyte, a special type of glial cell. So because this myelin sheath contains fat, this is why that white matter appear white in color. And the parts of the axon, nerve cell bodies, dendrites, etc. in the gray matter are non-myelinated. This is why the gray matter appear gray in color with the naked eye. So if you cut a section of a fresh brain, you can see with your naked eye gray matter outside like this and white matter inside. And this white matter appear white with the naked eye because of myelinated nerve fibers. Now these axons are supported by glial cells, which provide the physical and nutritional support, and there are blood vessels. So this is summary of the structure of the cerebral cortex. Now, if we cut a piece of the cerebral cortex, sulci and gyri, this is gray matter. Under it is the white matter. No, this is gray matter. Which is known as the cerebral cortex. In case of cerebrum. And deep to it is the white matter. Now in the gray matter, which appear gray in color, still you will see two white bands. An outer band and inner band. In fresh brain specimen, you can see these white bands in the gray matter with your naked eye. So this is known as outer band. And this is inner band. Outer band and inner band of Bellarger. From here up to here, this is the gray matter, thickness of the cerebral cortex. It is gray in color and can be seen with the naked eye. But still you can see two white bands. One is outer and the other is inner. Known as the outer band of Bellarger and inner band of Bellarger. Now you know in the cerebral cortex there are various centers. Auditory center, visual center, motor cortex, sensory cortex, etc. Now here in the occipital pole is the visual cortex, visual center. Now what happens in the visual center, the outer band of Bellarger is thicker. Now, in this part of the cerebral cortex. You can see the outer band is, this is outer band, is thicker. Outer band of Belarger, and this is inner band. In the gray matter of cerebral cortex, there is an outer band and inner band of white matter, known as the outer band and inner band of Belarger. But when we reach the visual cortex, visual center, the cerebral cortex, where there is visual center, suppose this part of the cerebral cortex is in the occipital lobe, and in it there is visual center, visual cortex. Here you can see again the inner band of Belarger and the outer band. The outer band is more broader as compared to the inner band in the region of visual cortex, in the region of gray matter of visual cortex. This is known as the visual stria of Guennari. Visual stria of Guennari. So because the outer band of Belarger is broader, and this is the inner band of white matter which is narrower, this part of the cerebral cortex in which there is visual center, the bands are here known as the visual stria of Guennari. Now here in the visual center, with the naked eye, the cerebral cortex gives a striated appearance. Therefore, the visual cortex is also known as striated cortex. The visual cortex, because of the visual stria of Guennari, this gray matter gives a striated, a layered appearance. This is why the visual cortex of the cerebrum is also known as the visual cortex, also known as the striated cortex, because it gives a striated appearance. The thickness of the cerebral cortex vary. It varies from 1.5 millimeter to 4.5 millimeter. Thickness of cerebral cortex. In different parts, thicknesses differ from the other parts. It is from, in some areas it is 1.5 millimeter and in other areas it is 4.5 millimeter. So thickness of the cerebral cortex vary. Now, this was about the cerebral cortex, and deep to cerebral cortex is the white matter, in which I told you there are myelinated nerve fibers supported by glial cells and blood vessels, white matter. Now still in the white matter of each cerebellar hemisphere, there are masses of gray matter. Masses of gray matter. Known as the basal nuclei. Now still in the white matter of each cerebral hemisphere, in the basal half of each cerebral hemisphere, there are masses of gray matter collectively known as the basal nuclei. So in the cerebral sphere, the gray matter is distributed on the outer surface as the cerebral cortex and embedded within the white matter in the form of masses of gray matter. Masses of gray matter embedded in the white matter is known as nucleus. It is not the nucleus of the cell. Each mass of the gray matter comprised of millions of cells or neurons, but they are known as nuclei. So collection of neurons in the white matter of brain, in the white matter of cerebrum and cerebellum is known as a nucleus. So this was a summary of the gray matter and white matter of the cerebral cortex. Gray matter and white matter of the cerebrum. Now next part of the brain is cerebellum. It also comprises of gray matter and white matter. Just like in the cerebrum, gray matter, white matter. And just like in case of cerebrum, gray matter is outside and white matter is inside. Here again, the gray matter is outside and white matter is inside. And the gray matter of cerebellum is known as the cerebellar cortex. The gray matter of cerebrum, which is outside, is known as cerebral cortex, while the gray matter of the cerebellum, which is also located outside, is known as cerebellar cortex. Now if you cut a section through the cerebellum, this is posterior arch, it is an anterior arch, so it is a section showing gray matter outside and white matter inside. Now outside is gray matter, inside is white matter, and gray matter is known as cerebellar cortex. Now, what is the structure of the gray matter of the cerebellum? Same as that of cerebrum. That is, it comprises of nerve cell bodies, dendrites, and parts of the axons of the neurons, supported by glial cells and blood vessels. The white matter of the cerebellum and cerebrum, again, same structure, comprises of myelinated nerve fibers or axons, which traverse the white matter. Still in the white matter, there are masses of gray matter in the cerebellum. In each cerebellar hemisphere, there are masses of gray matter, nuclei, known as cerebellar nuclei. Just like in the white matter of cerebrum, there are a collection of gray matter or neurons in the form of nuclei called basal nuclei. Same is the case here. Embedded in the white matter of the cerebellum, there are masses of gray matter known as the nuclei, and because these nuclei in each cerebellar hemisphere, they are known as cerebellar nuclei. So both in the cerebrum and cerebellum, gray matter is outside, white matter is inside. And still in the white matter, there are nuclei. Now you know that the cerebrum comprises of right and left cerebellar hemisphere, and cerebellum comprises of right and left cerebellar hemisphere. In case of cerebrum, there are differences, gross anatomical and structural differences between right and left cerebral hemispheres. Just like I told you before, that the gyri and sulci of one cerebral hemisphere even do not match with the gyri and sulci of the other cerebral hemisphere in the same individual. Second, one cerebral hemisphere is dominant. For example, in right-handed people, it is the left cerebral hemisphere which is dominant. And in the left-handed people, it is the right cerebral hemisphere which is predominant. Because amongst the world population, there are more right-handed people. Therefore, mostly it is the left cerebral hemisphere which is dominant. But this is not the case as far as the cerebellum is concerned. Cerebellum also has right cerebellar hemisphere, left cerebellar hemisphere, but there are no differences between right and left cerebellar hemispheres. Now, next to cerebrum and cerebellum, what is the brief about the structure of the brainstem? And you know the brainstem comprises of midbrain, pons, and medulla oblongata. And medulla oblongata comprise of upper open part and lower closed part. Now, midbrain, if we cut a section through the midbrain, it also has a gray matter and white matter. Through the center of midbrain, you know, cerebral aqueduct traverses. So there is central gray matter which surrounds the cerebral aqueduct. Central gray matter or periaqueductal gray matter. Central gray matter. And outside is white matter, in which are embedded different nuclei. For example, nuclei of some cranial nerves, and there are other type of nuclei also. So you have seen, in case of cerebrum, gray matter is outside, white matter is inside. In case of cerebellum, gray matter is outside, white matter is inside. While in case of midbrain, you can see the gray matter is inside, surrounding the aqueduct, known as the central gray matter. are peri-equidistant gray matter. Outside is mixture of gray and white matter. And the masses of gray matter in the white matter are different nuclei, which include cranial nerve nuclei. So this is a section through the midbrain. Next, let us first discuss the close part of the medulla oblongata. Close part, which is traversed by the central canal. Now suppose this is a section through the medulla oblongata, close part. This is the central canal which traverses through the close part of the medulla oblongata. In the close part of medulla oblongata, again, the central canal is surrounded by central gray matter. So gray matter is inside and white matter is outside in case of closed part of the medulla oblongata. Gray matter inside and white matter is outside. Still in the white matter, which is outside, there are different nuclei, including nuclei of the cranial nerves. Next, the open part of the medulla oblongata. Here in the open part, there is no central canal. Suppose this is a section through the open part of medulla oblongata. There is no central canal. So in the open part of medulla oblongata, there is a mixture of gray and white matter. White matter and gray matter. And the gray matter is in the form of masses of gray matter forming different nuclei, especially the cranial nerve nuclei. Next is pons. Like open part of the medulla oblongata, pons is also not traversed by central canal. So suppose if this is a section through the pons, there is a mixture of white matter and gray matter. And gray matter is in the form of different nuclei. So, in the cerebrum, gray matter is outside, white matter is inside. In cerebellum, gray matter is outside, white matter is inside. Still in the white matter of cerebrum and cerebellum, there are nuclei, masses of gray matter. In case of midbrain, because it is traversed by the cerebral aqueduct, it is surrounded by a gray matter, not the central gray matter. White matter is outside, opposite to that of cerebellum and cerebrum in midbrain. Gray matter is inside, surrounding the cerebral aqueduct. White matter is outside. Still in the white matter, there are masses of gray matter in the form of different nuclei, which include nuclei of the cranial nerves. Then pons. Pons is not traversed by central canal. So it comprises of a mixture of white matter and gray matter. This is white matter, and embedded in the white matter, scattered here there, are masses of gray matter in the form of different nuclei, including cranial nerve nuclei. Then come to the upper part, open part of the medulla oblongata. It is also not traversed by central canal because the central canal opens. So it is just like pons. It is a mixture of gray matter and white matter. It is white matter, and embedded in the white matter, there are different masses of gray matter in the form of nuclei, which also include cranial nuclei. Now come to the closed part of the medulla oblongata, because it is traversed by central canal. So the central canal is surrounded by gray matter. So in the closed part of medulla oblongata, gray matter is inside, white matter is outside. Just like the midbrain, gray matter is inside, white matter is outside. And in the white matter, masses of gray matter in the form of nuclei. Similarly, in the closed part, it is traversed by central canal. So gray matter is inside, which surrounds the central canal, and outside is white matter. Still embedded in the white matter, there are masses of gray matter in the form of different nuclei. So there are nuclei of cranial nerves in the brainstem. Which nuclei? From third to 12th cranial nerve nuclei. Embedded in the white matter of brainstem, apart from other nuclei, there are cranial nerve nuclei. Cranial nerve, which cranial nerve nuclei are in the brainstem, midbrain, pons, medulla oblongata, open part, closed part? Third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th, and 12th. From third to 12th cranial nerve nuclei are in the brainstem. Now, the spinal cord. Now if you cut a section through the spinal cord, again we can see the white matter and gray matter. Now this is a section through the spinal cord. Again, it is comprising of gray matter and white matter. So here you can see the spinal cord. It is traversed by central canal. It comprises of gray matter and white matter again. But gray matter is inside, and white matter is outside. Opposite to that of cerebrum and cerebellum. In cerebrum and cerebellum, gray matter is outside, white matter is inside. In case of spinal cord, the gray matter is inside and white matter is outside. So gray matter is surrounding the central canal. So in spinal cord, centrally located is the gray matter and outside is the white matter. The central gray matter is resembles the English letter H, having different parts. For example, this is anterior horn of gray matter, and this is posterior horn of gray matter, and this is the central canal, which passes through the center of gray matter. And outside is the white matter in the form of funiculi, three funiculi in each half. These are known as the funiculi. And already we talk about it. This is anterior funiculus, this is lateral funiculus, and this is posterior funiculus. So white matter is divided in each half of the spinal cord into these three funiculi. So white matter is outside in the form of funiculi, and gray matter is inside, which is in the form of various parts like anterior horn, which run anterolaterally, posterior horn, which run posteriorly, and in the central part of the gray matter is traversed by the central canal. So gray matter is inside, white matter is outside, opposite to that of cerebellum and cerebrum in case of spinal cord.